Tristan. Michael from Red Chair Diaries over here across the many oceans and in Nova Scotia, Canada. Anyway, your video is very, very confusing to me, for one thing. Taking into account the video you did about the credit cards, and I understand you and your partner are going shopping, but still it seemed like a big expenditure and whatever, an unnecessary one, because your TV is not that old. Now, you know that I have done everything that you have done in the past. I told you that, except by a car, except by the the BMW. But it just does seem like quite a lavish expenditure. Now, regardless of that, I thought you were living in an apartment, and do you actually have room for a 60-inch screen? Because there is a rule of thumb, and I don't know what the ratio is right now, that you have to sit farther back the bigger the TV is. And in a way, you actually end up losing some of the benefit of getting a bigger television. I use my 32-inch 720 here as a monitor, but I can't get too close to it. Sometimes the picture is no bigger than if I'm using a laptop, if you know what I mean. But and I can't invest in 3D because I am blind in my right eye, and I've never seen anything in 3D, including the real world. So, you know, it's 2D for me. And that whole thing about the one pair of glasses is very, very bizarre. Because when I've seen the 3D TVs advertised here, and they're advertised every week in our Future Shop and our Best Buy flyers, which we get every week, sometimes it's two pairs, but quite often it's four pairs. And if you're going in for a 60-inch television, there is something really wrong with that equation. And I think that the glasses quite often are part of what the manufacturer supplies, you know, so that they would probably have that sort of logo on them and all that. So I don't understand that at all. I think that you might want to check out at the manufacturer's website, and which you may have already done, and just see if they even mentioned the glasses, because it doesn't make sense. You know, I mean, I could see that if you're buying a 20-inch 3D TV that only one person could watch, you know, because you'd want to be in the center of it. But 60-inch, 5 feet diagonally, doesn't seem to jive with what I've read before. And I feel like that same thing happened to me, but I don't remember the circumstance about, you know, come in and then you go in and it's not there. Oh, it just is enough to make you smash something on the premises, because it's just so bogus, you know. I mean, we have major chains of in Canada that are well known for trying to pump you up to, you know, you go in to buy a consumer good on special and they always seem to be sold out, you know, or they had five. I mean, I went into a drugstore once to look into buying a netbook that was the major chain and that they were had on sale, and it was gone because they were only sent one, you know, by that sort of nonsense, you know. Anyway, but I mean, those are my comments, and to spend all that extra money for the for that DVD or Blu-ray, whatever. But it reminds me, you know, I've told the story before, but when I first got my first VHS, and it was $1,200 or $1,400, you know, and a blank tape was $28, a blank one. And that's way back in 81. So, but you're still getting so much more for your money these days. It really is something. I mean, we've got 3 HD TVs in this house. Ted's all-in-one HP has a 1080 screen, his HP computer. It doesn't come with a Blu-ray drive, but it has 1080 HP. And It just makes you wonder, you know, like how many consumer products some of us need, because, you know, we've certainly gone overboard, and we have must have watched 4 Blu-ray movies since we got that Blu-ray player, as far as I can make out. I think we've watched less than 1 a month. And I'm thinking about, you know, when you're talking about the 3D movies, you know, you're amassing quite a library of 2D movies. So, you know, that is a Rolls Royce, but you're going to be putting, you know, regular gasoline in it, sort of thing, you know, because you've got those other movies. So sometimes it just doesn't make sense. But I would like to have a 60-inch TV, say, only if I turn my library into a media room. That's the only place it could go. It, even with that fairly large living room we have, it just, there's not really any place to put it because of the way the room is rectangular. And at one end of the rectangle is the large window, and at the other end is the, you know, the dining area and the kitchen. So, you know, that room cannot support a huge television. I mean, we've got the 40-inch one in there, and that's it. And I think that's about it, what I wanted to say. So, I hope the TV actually, you know, works out for you, because I know that you're really enjoying these movies. About the Star Wars, I'm surprised you haven't seen more of those. You've only seen the first one, you said, which I think you mean, yeah, you mean the A New Hope, I guess, the one he called Episode 4 from 1977. Never been a big Star Wars fan, but yes, I have seen them all. I saw the first, I mean, the first trilogy in the theaters as they came out. That was 77, 80, and 83. And I own one movie only. I own Return of the Jedi on Laserdisc. And then the other ones, I think I might have gone to the theater only to see one of the second trilogy, which is the first trilogy. You see, it's very confusing, isn't it? But I've always been kind of underwhelmed by them, even though they're, you know, pyrotechnically they're quite something, obviously. A lot of eye candy for sure. But no content. I mean, you know, George, what is his name anyway? My God. It's been warm here today. No, I can't remember. George Lucas. He is something like James Cameron, and the fact that he can't actually, he's not a good writer when it comes to narrative. You know, I mean, Cameron is very clunky. Very, very clunky. Lucas is worse for dialogue and all that sort of stuff. But the rest of what they come up with is marvelous, isn't it? It really is something. So, you know, I can understand that there's a whole following for all of that sort of stuff. Anyway, I wanted to kind of like respond in a longer reply to you, for because you touched on many, many subjects there. So, anyway, Michael from Red Chair Diaries, full of shit as usual, and you have a good weekend down there. I'm selling fish this weekend for 3 days, so Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. Bye-bye.